Ladies and gentlemen, next fight in the biggest three rounds of the Cage Warriors Academy Ireland Bantamweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, weighing in at 135 pounds. With a fight record of 2 wins, no defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of Team Rhino, presenting Graeme Sheehan. With an MMA record of no wins with 1 defeat. Fighting out of Ivory, presenting Stephen O'Neill.
In the bantamweight division, we have had an exceptional night of fights so far and finishes. In the bantamweight division, we have Stephen O'Neill out of Ivory taking on Graeme Sheehan out of Team Rhino. Sheehan wearing the black shorts with the Rhino logo, taking on Stephen O'Neill, who's in the black shorts with Venom. Of course, I called out there at the start an 0-1 fighter in Stephen O'Neill, but vastly experienced K-1, a Muay Thai fighter.
Oh, and there is exhibit A of it. Straight away. That lead switch kick straight off, serious, serious power. You can see the experience there. Well, in fairness, Graeme Sheehan, two older brothers. Matthew, I can't think, he'll kill me now for forgetting his other brother's name, but a family of MMA athletes.
But you can really see the difference in physique. It's a young man fighting a man, really. But you can see when O'Neill throws the kick, there's not much tell on the man. He really buries it in. But a good reply there with Sheehan, a leg kick of his own. Nice right hand.
It won't show him off, Noel. I just see him in the gym. He takes the toughest guys every time, regardless of size or height or weight. He'll always take a tough sparring partner or grappling partner. So he's always up for a challenge on Graeme Sheehan.
Again, that levy head kick really burying into the thigh of Sheehan. But Sheehan just walking through them. Good body kick as well. And a nice step away left hook by O'Neill.
For a young guy, Noel, he is an intelligent fighter as well, especially having the two older brothers there, both medal at the Worlds at an amateur level. They will be, I'm sure they'll be discussing techniques and tactics all week at home.
And you just see Sheehan worked his way in nicely there to close the distance. Good strength by O'Neill up against the cage and pinpoint knees to the solar plexus as well of Sheehan.
He has to be careful taking these shots, Noel. He's taken too many heavy shots to the head. All right, yet again, that left hook, although hitting the guard, it will break the guard. 2 or 3 more days, it'll start breaking the guard. So he has to start moving that head, maybe even closing the distance, start giving Stephen O'Neill something to think about, give him a different looking set of a body standing in front of him with a bit of head movement.
Nice combinations, crisp combinations by Stephen O'Neill. And young Sheehan is getting picked apart here at the moment, and Stephen O'Neill looks like he's just turning the pressure up. But Sheehan comes back with a couple of combinations of his own. That lead leg is starting to get heavy, though. He felt that when he could see it start to redden up as well now, Stephen.
That left hook that he connected with did open up the right eyelid of, eyebrow of Stephen O'Neill.
So again, you can see Sheehan is landing a bloody nose on it for Sheehan as well. So
it's a high risk game plan, Donal. You know, stand in front of a guy that has heavy shots like that, and you're allowing him to land a heavy shot just to trade on him. It is a dangerous game plan. I'd like to see Graeme being a small bit more intelligent.
You got to give credit to O'Neill, though. He is a Muay Thai fighter. The corner knows he's a Muay Thai fighter, but he has brought Sheehan into a Muay Thai fight here. It's a mixed martial arts fight. Sheehan needs to close the distance maybe and make it an MMA fight, but so far you got to say Stephen O'Neill has had the more success, although Sheehan has landed some good shots. He's wearing it, and
again,
he goes high with the kick.
That left head kick every time, though. If he's not breaking the guard, he is landing it. I'd like to see Graeme now say, all right, look, we've done your game for a round. We've stood. Now let me show you what I'm made of. Maybe take it to the ground, mix it up, start wrestling a small bit, as well as mixing in the striking with it. But given Stephen O'Neill a different look, I think standing in front of him, it is dangerous. Going into the second round, these shots are going to start adding up.
Round two, a fresh round here for Graeme Sheehan. So he done something well in the first round where he peppered a 2 or 3 shot combination to close the distance, but he couldn't get it to the mat. I'd like to see him try to do that again. Plenty of head movement by Sheehan this time. A little bit of urgency as well, and a good teep by O'Neill to it.
It really is a beautiful style of striking. You can see how solid Stephen O'Neill is in that. But it's like you say, now take him out of comfort zone. Let's give him a bit of adversity. See if he comes out the other side of it.
Go
beautiful low single,
switch
to the double, and he still chases Graham Sheehan. Chase the takedown right to the cage.
That's what we wanted to see from Sheehan, and that's what we've got. So now we've got O'Neill in the MMA world.
Sheehan has to be careful of going for that lateral drop with a guy with. He has heavy hips.
Good underhook. Good underhook there by O'Neill, and he's now in top position. So O'Neill's shown he's more than just a Muay Thai fighter. Good defense and scrambles to get back to this position. I'd expect him to stand up and get away, but he hasn't. He's dived into the half guard.
I'm sure he's been in the position before. He has Richie Ivory in his corner there, a brown belt around a long, long time.
Hand as well on top, and Sheehan is just trying to maybe push in. Shrimp into O'Neill, and he has done that. Good work. It's back on their feet, but one underhook there on the left-hand side by Graham Sheehan. It's them knees. Them knees are devastating. It's such a short range as well. Pinpoint. O'Neill gets it to the ground again. But you think Sheehan would be happy? He's probably happier that it's here. Even though he's on the bottom, he's probably happier to be on the mat, Stephen.
The approach he's taking, it's more subtle. You can see O'Neill is aggressive. He's looking for the finish constantly. Where Graham is, not that he's biding his time for something to happen, but he's not enforcing his will enough. I'd like to see him hit the takedowns, close the distance more.
This is something that might slow O'Neill down, although he's fought MMA before. That little bit of grappling could all of a sudden slow the kicks, could slow the shots coming in. Doesn't look to have done that at the moment, just working behind a jab, Stephen O'Neill.
He still looks very comfortable now, throwing that overhand right.
It was a beautiful overhand right, and Graham Sheehan shows he can wear it. Coming forward himself, just looking for that right hand down the pipe. O'Neill, that step in knee again, and maybe starting to look just a little more, not as technical, throwing the shots. William gets
right
caught on the right.
Graham Sheehan. This has to start taking its toll now. The two guys, the majority of round one, majority of round two, apart from a little a takedown transition, the guys have been standing in front of each other, throwing those kicks into the legs, throwing them right hands, left hands into the head.
It's a high tempo, high pace fight, and you would think it'd wear it on you. It's almost becoming a war of attrition in that sense. And O'Neill goes
for the takedown like right at the end of the round.
A big pro move there. Heard the clapper, initiated the takedown. Sheehan done well to get out of it, but what a fight. Two unbelievably fast-paced round by both fighters. But both fighters had their success in it. You can't see, they're both wearing it a little on their face, but it'll be interesting to see the tempo of the third round here. O'Neill, I wouldn't say he's breathing heavy, but he's not as comfortable as he was in the middle of the second round. With the pace, you'd fully expect that.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's seen that Graham Sheehan is willing to come here and give him a fight. You know, he's not going to walk over. I think he appreciates it a bit now. He's going to come into the third round now a bit more. Oh, beautiful lead kick again.
In some ways for O'Neill, though, you got to be thinking, I've hit this kid with everything. I've peppered that leg, I'm landing hooks, I've landed head kicks, and he's still walking me down and coming forward. He walks behind a double jab and just misses with the right hand, and a right hand counter just off target by Sheehan. Nice body kick. Nice right hand of his own here by Graham Sheehan.
He got caught.
That was beautiful right hand. Just behind the ear to take away the equilibrium, and Stephen O'Neill gets it done in round three. A highly contested fight. We were interested to see the judges' scorecards. I'm still interested to see it, but Stephen O'Neill has not fought in MMA. I think it's over 4 years, maybe longer. But big comeback by Stephen O'Neill.
It's a high risk game plan, that Noel, going in and trading with a striker of that caliber. In fairness, he did go three rounds, but you know it's a big risk.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 37 seconds of round number three. For your winner, by winner.